أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سورة السجدة الآية 23 23 إن شاء الله. الحمد لله وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على حبيبنا رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أصبحنا وأصبح الملك لله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه واجعلنا هداة مهديين غير ضالين ولا مضلين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. الله سبحانه وتعالى سأل إن سورة السجدة آية نمبر 23 ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب فلا تكن في مرية من لقائه وجعلناه هدى لبني إسرائيل. Indeed, we give the scripture to Musa عليه السلام. So let there be no doubt, O Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, that you too are receiving revelations, and we made it a guide for the children of Israel. Every one of us goes through some difficulties sometimes, and we have challenges in our life. Everyone, no exception, along with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam spent 23 years in his life calling people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, guided them, showing them the right path, but not most of them, but he found, as you know, difficulties, especially in the Mecca period. 13 years, people, they called him Sahir, Kathab, Majnoon, you are crazy, you are a liar, you are not a prophet, you are not a messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And at that moment, he is a human being, he is Bashar. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. He is prophet. He knows he is a prophet, he knows he is a messenger. But in fact, when he goes through the people around him, he found difficulties. 3 years, da'wah sirriya, secret and hidden da'wah, hidden Islam. After that, 10 years, his people, his companions, his sahaba, killed in front of his eyes, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he couldn't do anything. Not only that, Abu Lahab, his uncle, لهذا جمعتنا تبا لك لهذا جمعتنا. For that you gathered us, that's why you called us to sit and to listen to say لا إله إلا الله, and there is no God but Allah, to leave our idols and our asnam, awthan, to worship Allah. تبا لك, curse you, and his uncle, تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب. So let us imagine the feeling of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم at that moment. Sometimes he get not weak, but he hope all people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to feel that happiness, that connection with their creator, their Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. So every time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his some like encouragement, some stories about prophets and messengers before him, about people before his people, about nations before his nation. Here he said, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابِ. O Muhammad, remember, walaqad, meaning, O Muhammad, remember, put that in your mind all the time. You are not alone in this way. You are not alone in this mission. We sent all prophets and messengers, and they did the same thing. And their people also, they rejected their da'wah. Not all people will be in the same level, in the same position in the eye of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who works hard and accepted da'wah, accepted Islam, accepted the nur and the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will be in different level than the other. He didn't do anything. وَلَقَدْ أَتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابِ. We sent kitab and guidance and instructions to Musa as we sent it to you. فَلَا تَكُنْ فِي مِرْيَةٍ مِنْ لِقَائِهِ. Don't have doubt that you will meet the same goal of Musa alayhi salam. We have many tafasil about this, but do not have doubt that you are messenger. You are going to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one day. You are going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yawm al-qiyamah. And Allah azza wa jalla will give each one what he deserves. وَجَعَلْنَاهُ هُدًى لِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. And that book of Musa, Torah, we made it as what? As a guidance to the children of Israel. those who followed that guidance, followed that book, they will enter Jannah. And those didn't do that, they will not. Always Hidayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ready. وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ Al-Hidayah mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the guidance came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For who? For the one who is ready to receive that Hidayah. If I have car, but I'm not ready to drive it. So I'm not a driver because I didn't have the driver license. I didn't have enough training to drive. So we have car, but we don't have driver. We have book, but where is the reciter? Or where is the believer? The one who is ready to receive that khair and that nur. How many masahif we have? We are not lacking in masahif. Every day, the publishers and the Majma' al-Malik Fahd in Medina, they, mashallah, they give millions of copies of masahif. So for the hard copy mushaf, we don't have issue, alhamdulillah. But the issue is, we don't have also issue with reading Quran al-Karim. The big issue to understand and apply, practice Quran al-Karim in our daily life. This is the issue. And this is the difference between us and the Sahaba of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They said we recite 10 ayat by 10 ayat, and we don't pass these 10 ayat until we understand it, memorize it, understand it, practice it. Then we go to other portion in Quran al-Karim. Now, sometimes, yes, we don't have that understanding. Battery is dead. Yes. I don't know if. وَجَعَلْنَاهُ هُدًى لِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ May Allah Azza wa Jal make Quran al-Karim huda for Bani Muhammad, for Ummat Muhammad, inshallah. As Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned that the Torah, the guidance in Torah came as Hidayah, a guidance to the children of Israel. So here Allah Azza wa Jalla like telling us, giving us a message, and Quran is a Hidayah and guidance to you and your Ummah. Take it as a Hidayah. Look at Quran al-Kareem, a book of Hidayah, a book of guidance, a book of Nur, a book of life. Without this book, we cannot have that happiness in our life. And every one of us is looking for that happiness, that tranquility, that peace. So we will find all of these in the Quran al-Kareem. After that, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ It is very important, and maybe this is the ayah, we can take it from this surah, Surah Al-Sajda, to be imam. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً Imam should be in amam, in front. Imam, meaning he is a leader. He is a good example, role model. And people will follow him, will follow his footsteps. طيب, how can be imam? Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us all to be imams. Imam at your home. Not only leading salah is easy thing. Imam in akhlaq, imam how to deal with others, imam at your work, you are the best, imam at your school, you are the best, number one, always you are number one in everything. How can we be in first place? Three conditions, Allah mentioned them in Quran al-Karim, in this ayah. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا And we made and we raised from among them leaders guiding by our command when they patiently endured and firmly believed in our signs وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُ وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ Three things. يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا Surah Hidayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and guide people through the the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ittiba' al-Qur'an, ittiba' al-Sunnah, it is part of our mission in this life. لا تبتدع, اتبع ولا تبتدع. اتباع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم علامة النجاح والفلاح. يهدون بأمرنا. Number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before I take any decision, before I take any thing in my life, any action, I should put that in the scale of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is it okay? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said yes, that's fine. If Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم accept that, it will be under the hidayah of Allah. يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا, under the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I should not put always my opinion, my opinion, my opinion. What is the opinion of Allah? What is the opinion of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? That's fine if I have suggestions or opinions, but the condition of that, not to be against Quran al-Kareem or Sunnah. So يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا, always I have to put Allah and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in front of my eye before I take any decision, before I do anything in my life. الهداية بأمر الله, يهدون بأمر الله. لما صبروا, الصبر, صبر, صبر, صبر. And the صبر, there is few types of a صبر. صبر على طاعة الله, صبر عن معصية الله, وصبر على الشدائد. صبر, to have صبر, to be patient when you worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Practicing عبادة needs صبر. Salah needs sabr. Coming to Fajr to pray at Masjid, going to Hajj, spending money, these, all of these things, it is ibadah, needs sabr. Sabr an ma'asiyat Allah, and sabr for siyam, 30 days, 29 days, Shah Ramadan, needs sabr. If someone has no sabr, he cannot fast. And sabr, and the school of siyam, the greatest school, to build that skill in the believers, to have enough sabr to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have siyam from Fajr till Maghrib, every day, no food, no drink, no permissible desires, al-mubahat. That mubahat, it is permissible, it is halal, but now, no. So I have to have sabr. This period, not allowed to drink, not allowed to eat, not allowed to touch my wife. Okay, oh, خير إن شاء الله, صبر. It is صبر, yes. يهدون بهم لما صبروا. صبر عن معصية الله, avoid haram, avoiding haram. Every day we face haram, and this test, part of our test in this life, to see haram every day and to say إني أخاف الله. وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا وَاسْتَبَقَ الْبَابِ. So always as a man or as a woman, we will have challenging, we will have shaitan, we will have nafs ammara bisu pushing us to commit minor or major sins, but we have to have sabr عن مَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ. Big challenge, especially in this environment, in this society. And may Allah protect our children, protect our youth. Last kind of sabr, al-sabr ala al-shada'id. We have challenging in our life, sickness, losing your job, losing your business, losing your money, losing your health, losing your wealth, losing someone from your family members. We need to have sabr. Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Al-lazina idha asabatum musib, wa lanabluwannakum bishay'in min al-khawf, wal-ju'a, wa naqsum min al-amwal, wal-anfus, wal-thamarat, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Give them glad tidings. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّهُمْ. He said, we are going to test you. In what? In everything in your life. Everything. No exception. In your family, your loved ones, your work, your job, your people around you. We don't know. Every day, we expect to have tests. What kind of test? We don't know. Allah knows. He said, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّهُمْ. بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ. Sometimes from fear, خوف والجوع, hunger, ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات. طيب نعم, وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. We belong to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم إيش؟ المهتدون. We are talking about هداية now. يهدون بأمرنا لما صبروا وأولئك هم المهتدون. So Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned هداية a couple of times in the Quran al-Kareem, especially with صبر. And these are the qualities of believers. يهدون بأمرنا لما صبروا. So we need to improve our skill with صبر. وكانوا بآياتنا يوقنون. This is the last quality. To be imam, to be leader at the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وكانوا بآياتنا يوقنون. يوقنون, to have yaqeen, no doubt in every single word or ayah in Quran al-Kareem. Allah Azza wa Jalla promised us, وعد الله الذين آمنوا منكم وعملوا الصالحات. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, Allah promised you. Allah promised, if you do good, if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you do your good deeds, you will enter al-Jannah. And Allah Azza wa Jalla will give you that dignity in this earth. And Allah will give you that good position. Okay, do we believe in this promise or not? يوقنون. Allah mentioned yaqeen in Quran al-Kareem. How many times? Surah Al-Baqarah, Alif Lam Mim, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون. يقين. وكانوا بآياتنا يوقنون. Believers, هم يوقنون. If we don't reach that level of يقين, يقين to believe and to trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything. يقين to see Jannah and Nar in front of your eyes all the time. يقين in the hadith of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Whatever he said, it is يقين, no doubt. No doubt. يقين in آخرة. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليكرم ضيفه فليحسن إلى جاره فل. So that يقين connected with آخرة. If I feel that yaqeen in my heart, so I am leader. I am good leader. I am good leader. And Allah Azza wa Jal will give me that ability to guide others. يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا وَكَانُوا بِأَيَاتِنَا. This is three qualities. الْهِدَايَةَ and always اتِّبَاعَ. يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا. I need to have that knowledge. Study Islam well. Study Quran al-Kareem well. Study the Sunnah well. Study fiqh, study tafsir. When I give, unfortunately, if we don't have that hidayah enough, people will run away from Islam. People will not love masjid. And unfortunately, I have a story. If we don't, يعني من أفتى بغير علم فقد ضل وأضل. If you give fatwa without knowledge, you misguide yourself and you misguide others. وأجرأكم على الفتية أجرأكم على النار. Thou needs rush and hurry to give fatwa, to give answers without knowledge, without authentic fatwa, authentic knowledge. He is pushing himself to go to Jahannam. Because when you say halal, what that means you are talking in behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you said it is haram, you are talking in behalf of Allah or in behalf of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So saying that, you need to be careful. Many stories about people, they give fatwa or give answers, and people, they run away from Islam or run away from masjid or run away from the Muslim community. Unfortunately, you say sometimes a person said, Ya akhi, wallahi, I love to deal with non-Muslim more than dealing with Muslim. Ya akhi, hold on. خير إن شاء الله. Because I dealt with Muslim, his name Muhammad and Abdullah and Ahmed and Mustafa and Abdul Rahman, and they break their promise and they didn't perform their work well. They didn't give the right to their workers. Or, but when I deal with that person, he's non-Muslim, always perfect in everything, complete their contract on time. It is not in general. We have some stories like this. Why? Yani, if you talk and you give 10 hours lectures, 100 hours lectures about صدق, to be a trustworthy person, to say the truth to your children. You are saying that all the time, all the time. And after all these lectures, saying, talking about the importance of صدق, the amana, and one day, one knocked the door at your house, or someone called you phone, and you tell your son, tell him I'm not here. Tell him I'm not here. Okay, what about your 100 hours lectures about صدق? All of that went out to trash. خلاص. Delete. So يهدون بأمرنا لما صبروا وكانوا بآياتنا يوقنون. Saying things and apply it and practicing it in your life by actions, by to be good example, to be good leader, role model by actions. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يهدون بأمر الله واجعلنا ممن يصبرون واجعلنا ممن يوقنون يا رب العالمين. إن ربك هو يفصل بينهم يوم القيامة فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون. Indeed your Lord will decide between them on the day of judgment regarding their differences. Yes, always we say, I am right, you are right. I have the strongest opinion in this matter. You have weak opinion. You are, okay, in the end, Allah knows best, and Allah will take care of us all. The unity of people, that should be our priority. The unity of people, all people, Muslim and non-Muslim. Because we need to have peace in this earth. Now you are seeing what is going on in Russia and Ukraine. Yani, no one, everyone will suffer. Everyone in this earth will suffer from any war. The unity is very important, especially in the group of Muslims. How many madhab we have? Okay, madhab, that's fine. It is rahma. The differences in Islam, it is rahmah, ikhtilaf, it is rahmah. But that differences should not be the reason to fight each other, the reason to not say salam to each other because you are Shafi'i and I am Hanafi. You are doing qunut in Fajr, I don't do qunut in Fajr, so I cannot pray behind you. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. What kind of Islam we have? The unity. إن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاعبدون. هو سماكم المسلمين. You are Muslim. After you say I am Muslim, لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, خلاص. You enter this circle of Islam. No differences after that. The differences should be individuals, not to bring it to the table and to fight for that. SubhanAllah, some people, they have mindset, they just discuss differences and they want to prove they are right. I have one group. I talk with, he put me an admin in that group. All of them imams, scholars, and we graduated from the same big Islamic university. MashaAllah, more than 100. So sometimes, when you deal with ulama or with student of knowledge, they have knowledge, they have hadith, Quran, they read a lot. But and always we have differences in opinions, many things. Yahi, I notice every time somebody posts something in that group, other person will come to prove it is wrong, and he has many evidence for that. And the other person will come to prove something else against. So you spend many hours to read the differences and the conversations. For what? For something, it is not principle, it is not part of the foundation of Islam. And in the end, one of them will leave that group. يا أخي اتق الله. اتق الله. You want to show your muscle? You want to show your knowledge? خلاص يا أخي. He is saying لا إله إلا الله, accept him. Accept him, you have something else to do. You have many things in your life to do. That we need to have peace. Always. We have this mindset in our lives, in our personality. Always, if I have something in front of me, I don't like it. Shaitan, okay. Talk with him. Bring him your evidence, your proofs. Tell him this, send him this. شو يا أخي خلاص leave it. الاختلافات هذه it is اختلاف, it is differences, it is not principle, it is not pork, it is not wine, alcohol to say حلال or حرام. خلاص something it is clear حرام, no discussion. It is ربا, no discussion about it. But for small minor things to make war and to have no peace at your family, at your community, at your masjid, at your school, with your friends, at your job. Leave it. Inna rabbaka huwa yafsul. Leave it to Allah. Allah will take care yawm al-qiyam. Allah will judge between these people yawm al-qiyam. Awalam yahdi lahum kam ahlakna min qablihim. Min al-qurun yamshuna fi masakinihim. Inna fi dhalika la ayatin afala yasma'un. It is not yet clear to them how many peoples we destroyed before them. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said now to the people of Mecca, O people of Mecca, Quraysh, people of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what you are doing? Don't you see the people of Ad, Thamud, and Qawm Salih, and Fir'aun, the people of Fir'aun and Fir'aun himself, what happened for them? And you know, and you walked through their areas, through their houses, through their villages. And you see what happened for them when they rejected the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do not wait till Allah Azza wa Jal sent his punishment upon you. The smart person and the wise person, the one who accept the message without any punishment, the one who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before his punishment. As we mentioned last week, some people, they don't accept a message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they don't practice Islam, or they don't come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until they have severe pain, severe punishment, severe message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To have big accident, car accident, or to lose his loved ones from his family member, or to lose his job, or his wealth, or Ya Allah, now I will open a new page with you, Ya Allah, and I came back to you. It is good. Alhamdulillah, he came before Yawm al-Qiyamah. It is still the door of Tawbah opened. But the smart one, he should not wait until that moment. He should not, because he might not have that chance. أَوَلَمْ يَهْدِي لَهُمْ كَمْ أَلَكْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنَ الْقُرُونِ يَمْشُونَ فِي مَسَاكِنِهِمْ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ. It is big signs. You should not wait for the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to come to yourself. At least you see what happened for others. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ أَفَلَا يَسْمَعُونَ. Don't you hear? لَهُمْ أَذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ بِهَا. لَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ. They have eyes but they cannot see. They have ears, but they cannot hear. They have hearts, but they cannot understand. Allah will mention this. It is for us. For us. Not for others. To take lessons. Do not be like them. Do not act like them. Be careful. This is lessons. And Allah loves us. That's why He told us about their stories. Alhamdulillah. Wallah, it is a great blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to mention, to have these stories and to tell us about people, about nations before Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what happened for them. And that's why Allah Azza wa Jalla saved Muslim Ummah from the punishment, from the destroyed. He didn't destroy them and he will not do that till Yawm al-Qiyamah. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Allah would not punish them while you are amongst them. It is mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And other reason, he will not punish the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. If you are seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you are repenting to him day and night all the time, so you will be good, inshallah. Even if you do some mistakes, you commit some sins, okay, that's fine. You come back to Allah, repent to him, seek forgiveness. Allah will accept you and Allah will forgive you. أولم يروا أننا نسوق الماء إلى الأرض الجرز فنخرج به زرعا تأكل منه أنعامهم وأنفسهم أفلا يبصرون. This is other sign of Allah سبحانه وتعالى to tell us open your eyes, study things around you, study the earth, study the heavens, study the stars, study the trees, study the animals. It is miracles from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah sent the water, the rain to that land, that farm, and there are no trees, no plants, no fruit. After that rain, after that water that Allah Azza wa Jalla sent, you can eat and you can enjoy the food from that farm. Now again, what they told the Prophet وَيَقُولُونَ مَتَى هَذَا الْفَتْحُ وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَدِقِينَ. They ask mockingly, they laugh at the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. When is the day of يوم القيامة؟ مَتَى هَذَا الْفَتْحُ وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَدِقِينَ. When is the day of final decision? If what you say is true, if you say if it is true, what is the يوم القيامة? Tell us, let us see يوم القيامة. This is a way of people, they don't, subhanAllah, think well. Always they laugh at others, laugh at the peacemakers, laugh at the believers sometimes. I remember when I was a child, Dr. Wael, I remember maybe 10 years, and may Allah have mercy upon my father, he sent me and my two, three brothers to Quran Institute to learn. And we have like good teacher, mashallah. Spent with him time every day, 3, 4, 5 hours. Every from Asr to Maghrib or to Isha, every day. So he taught us Quran, taught us Faqa, taught us Tafsir. So we pray on time. We sometimes say it is haram. Turn off the TV. One day I came back and we have a small TV, abyad wa aswad, black and white, and there is no channels, only Syrian channel. Only Syrian channel.
In Syria?
In Syria. I'm talking in 1990 or 1989, at that time. 89, 88. I came back, and our teacher said, do not waste your time with like something that will not get benefit from it. And sometimes you see in the TV haram stuff. Haram stuff, we should avoid it. And we should use everything in wise way. So, and you have to do ma'ruf. And it is general. Al-amr al-ma'ruf wa-nahy al-munkar. To change ma'ruf by your hand, at least by your tongue, or by your heart. So I went back to home. So I saw munkar. TV, there is, you see TV, white and black, and yani, it is from yani, Syrian, only Syrian channel we have. Just music or songs or maybe things, but it's not that haram comparing with other. So I said, let me practice this hadith. If you see haram, you have to change it by your hand. And I have authority to do, I have something to do. But if I break it, I will have big punishment from my father or my mother. Although they will give me any good time with my legs. And my father has good sticks, always put it in the shelf. This is for sinners. This is for wrongdoers. So what I will do? I cannot touch it. It is money and my father brought it. What I should do? I went to behind that TV and play with that button. Tick, 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 tick. And khalas, channels like tashwish. No more picture, no more. If you open it, run it on, khalas. Just noise. No picture and no sound. And my family members, they came to open the TV, nothing. What happened? I don't know. By itself. What happened, Akhi? Wallahi, this morning was working well. And I just look at them. Then my father came, my mother came. Akhi, what's wrong? And I just remain silent. Rahabi, what happened? What kind of changing monkey you are doing?
So they sent it to the shop, to the store, and that person fixed it in a second. take it back. And I came back again. I remember it now, maybe 30, 35 years. To do good things, you need to talk with people. They have to have that message and to do that by themselves. So they mock. So some family members, they said, okay, Habi came. So they said, they called me Kaftaro. You know who is Kaftaro? You don't know? Who is the Mufti of Masr, Grand Mufti of Masr, of Egypt? Sheikh Tayyib? Sheikh Tayyib? Sheikh Tayyib?
No.
No? So, Kaftaro was a Grand Mufti of Syria. When I was around 10 years, 9 years old, 11 years old, and my family members, if I say, oh, it is wrong, it is haram, no, they say, Kaftaro came. Kaftaro is talking. Yeah, the Grand Mufti is talking now. And if they are doing something, it is not haram, but something funny. Okay, stop doing that now. Let Kaftaro go out, then we go. So they mock, laugh at me. This is a way of, can you imagine the people of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they mock at him and that they laugh at him, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And it is not something now normal, or simple things if we see that from our family members, but also this is a way of people, they laugh at others, especially for the peacemakers or the one who is guiding them. قُلْ يَوْمَ الْفَتْحِ لَا يَنْفَعُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِيمَانُهُمْ وَلَا هُمْ يُنْظَرُونَ. The day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, the day of judgment, there is no benefit for disbelievers, for the wrongdoers, for الظالمين. خلاص. It's game over. No more time, no more chance to do anything. فَأَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ وَانْتَظِرْ إِنَّهُمْ مُنْتَظِرُونَ. So you can work with other people. أعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ. If you work hard with them, you did your best with them, and they didn't, خلاص, leave them, go to other people. And this is also rule. It is good to have it. It is good skill. Always work with people they love to work with you, especially in the, like, as a teamwork. Teamwork, some people, they don't like to work. They always put obstacle, put the stick in the wheel. This person, it is hard to work with him. خلاص, leave him, work with others. Work with others, don't fight him. Don't, because if you spend your life fighting with him, خلاص, he has his mindset and you have other mission, you have something good to do. Do it with people. Work with people. Always in the school, you will have, if you have 40 teachers, you will have at least 5 teachers. Always they say no for anything, for any decision, as a principal or as a teamwork at that school. You will have few teachers to say no at your company. You will have some people to say no for everything, to have argument. Well, that's fine. Leave them. Work with people they believe in your mission or your vision. Work with them, and don't spend or don't lose your time with these kind of people. فَأَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ وَانْتَظِرْ إِنَّهُمْ. So Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he went to Taif. Yes. He went to Al-Madina. أعرض عنهم وانتظر. And wait for Allah. Allah will take care of these people. They didn't work with you. And he sent people also out of Medina to other tribes. Sent the nur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the guidance to others. فأعرض عنهم وانتظر. إنهم منتظرون. May Allah Azza wa Jal make Quran Kareem guidance for us, inshallah ta'ala. Oh Allah, guide us all. Ya Allah, let us understand Quran Kareem well. With each ayah, with each verse, with each surah, to take lessons and to practice it in our life, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Any question?